And welcome back inside with Proactive. I'm Steve Darling as we take a look at another mining jurisdiction around the world, this time in dealing with Sweden and unleashing the opportunity. And to help me along through this tour through Sweden is the CEO of District Metals, Garrett Ainsworth. And Garrett, thank you very much for being with us once again.
Hey, thanks, Steve. It's great to be on with you and Christina.
Yeah, let's welcome Christina as well. She's the country manager for Business Sweden. It's Christina Keighren. And Christina, nice to meet you as well.
Thank you so much. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, we're super excited to learn more about mining in Sweden. And first off, Garrett, let's start with you and just talk about the opportunity that you have within Sweden and why Sweden was such an attractive market for District Metals.
Right. Yeah. So, I mean, we had a very long due diligence process in selecting, you know, Tom Tebow, our flagship project located in the Bergslagen district of South Central Sweden. And, you know, it really became apparent very quickly that Sweden is a go-to jurisdiction for mineral exploration and for mining. I mean, it's highly ranked with the Fraser Institute on a number of metrics year after year. There's a number of majors that are working there, such as Boliden, Lundin Mining, Agnico Eagle, and then, you know, previously Rio Tinto was in there, BHP, South 32, and there's a handful of junior companies as well. So Sweden's it's a powerhouse in terms of mining for Europe and supplying, you know, quite a healthy proportion of the iron, base, and precious metals. And, you know, the government agencies, I've had firsthand experience going through a permitting process, are very supportive of mining. And then going through community relations, very supportive broadly across that front as well, you know, very skilled labor force, and, you know, corporate taxes are quite low, you know, when you get down to the mining end of the spectrum. So all in all, it couldn't be happier. And this is, you know, we're about a year and a half into working in Sweden and we love it.
Yeah. Christina, I got a number of questions for you because I'm sure you get these a lot working with Business Sweden. So first off, there's been a long tradition of mining within the country. Is that right?
Yes. Sweden has a very long history when it comes to mining, actually going back thousands of years. But the first recorded mine in Sweden goes back to 11th century, so about 800 years ago. So yes, a long tradition and history. And over the years, Sweden has, of course, built up a great competence in the mining industry. And it is now one of the world leading nation when it comes to new technology and innovation for the mining industry with a high degree of productivity, I would say.
Yeah. And I understand Sweden is very underexplored. There's a lot of areas still with lots of opportunity.
Yes, and this is maybe one of those unknown facts that Sweden has a lot of unexplored areas, and this is what's making Sweden so attractive. It has a large technology minerals and metal deposits like graphite, cobalt, lithium, and nickel. It sits on the Fennoscandian shield, and it has similar geology like Canada as well, with iron, nickel, copper, lead, and gold as well. But yes, it is. There are lots of areas that are unexplored, and Sweden really welcome foreign companies to do exploration work in Sweden.
Christine, a lot of those companies will look obviously at costing and what it costs to operate there. There's a lot of advantages in Sweden right now as far as costing is concerned. Can you sort of address some of the key ones?
Yes, and I think this is something of an unknown fact about Sweden that is actually quite inexpensive to do exploration in Sweden. We have also low corporate taxes, and we have something that is very important is the fact that we have green energy and an abundance of electricity. So this is something we provide, green energy, and as you know, Northvolt is building their first battery factory in the northern part of Sweden, and one of the main reasons why they chose that destination is because of the abundance of electricity, green electricity, and also the closeness to the mines.
Garrett talked obviously earlier, Christina, about lower fees, lower taxes, and the support of the government. Can you talk about just how key that is when you're discussing potential companies that want to come to Sweden, the fact that having such a stable economy and a government that really backs mining is such a big plus right now?
Yes, I mean, Sweden is a small country. There's 10 million people, just over 10 million people. The mining industry is hugely important to Sweden, and the Swedish government is very keen on supporting that industry. So yes, we welcome foreign exploration companies to come to Sweden and to make it easier for them to do their work. And also, I would say the infrastructure in Sweden is so well developed that it makes it easier to do work, like Garrett was mentioning before, with good roads, railroads, and high competence of people. But yes, it is providing a very stable economy and a corruption-free economy as well, which is very reassuring for companies that come to Sweden.
Yeah. And Garrett, finishing up with you, just something that Christina touched on there, workforce. Is that something that is positive right now in Sweden, that there are people that can take these type of specialized jobs? And also the fact that she mentioned that the Swedish landscape is very similar to Canada as far as mining is concerned, and how that's sort of almost transferable.
Yes, yeah, I would agree with that last point for sure. In terms of labor force, I mean, from what we see, the amount of talent there is of, you know, high level geologists such as Rodney Allen, who's a technical advisor on district metals, Hein Rat, who's our country manager. I mean, these guys have been working in the Bergslagen for decades. There's a few others, Niels Janssen, Eric Lundstrom, and they're all, you know, ex-Boliden type guys, and they've grown up in you know, the Bergslagen as their backyard. So you know, from an exploration standpoint, for sure, there are a lot of very, very skilled geologists, and you know, with the mining that they do at, say, Garpenberg, at Boliden's Garpenberg mine or Lundin's Zinkgruvan, they're using the utmost technology that's possible, you know, going to electric where possible. They're mining down at the 1400 meter level at Zinkgruvan and at Garpenberry, and they're doing it very cost effectively. It's $43 US per ton OPEX down at that depth. It's very impressive. So it's a very skilled labor force for sure.
And Christina, one last question for you. You mentioned a bit earlier about the battery factory that's going in the northern part of Sweden. Does the country, even though it's small, hope to become a big player as far as battery metals are concerned?
Yes, it is. This is a huge investment and very important to the Swedish economy, but also to the European economy. So this is a factory that will provide batteries, not just for Sweden, but to the European market. And yes, it is one of the major investments going on in Sweden right now, along with other things. The northern part of Sweden is going through a bit of a boom right now because of the abundance of renewable energy, low cost, like we have the cheapest electricity in Europe, and the skilled labor force. So a lot of attraction to the northern part of Sweden right now.
All right. Well, Christina, thank you so much. Great to meet you and learn a little bit more about your country. Appreciate the time today. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
All right. That's Christina Keighren. She is the country manager for Business Sweden. And Garrett, as always, we've only just begun to sort of scratch the surface of Sweden in the mining industry. So we look forward to you joining us in episode number 2.
Yes, there's lots to talk about. Thank you, Steve.
All right, there's Garrett Ainsworth, the CEO of District Metals, and I'm Steve Darling with Proactive as we look at Sweden unleashing the opportunity.